Hello everyone, today I'm going to talk about a general and efficient approach to verifying traffic load properties under arbitrary key failures. I am Ruihan Li from Peking University. This work was done when I was an intern at Alibaba Cloud. This is a joint work between Alibaba Cloud and Peking University. Alibaba Cloud operates a global one that interconnects multiple ISPs and dozens of data centers around the world. This one supports services such as cloud computing and e-commerce, and is designed to tolerate random failures up to degree K. However, in reality, random failures still cause problems, resulting in customer complaints and economic losses. Therefore, to prevent outages, it is important to formally answer questions at the implementation level. Will the network still function after the arbitrary key router or link failures? Answering this question requires a definition of the desired network properties. A basic set of network properties is related to reachability, such as whether packets from router C can reach another router D. These properties are qualitative and have been studied extensively in the last decade. Huoyan, published at SIGCOMM'20, is a system that can verify such properties and has been used in R1 for years. Another set of network properties related to traffic load, such as whether link could be loaded. These properties are quantitative and have only received attention in the last few years. Therefore, state-of-the-art works still face fundamental limitations. QARC, published at PLDI20, lacks generality because its shortest path-based modeling cannot be easily extended to support the complex protocols used in R1. Our previous work, Jingguban, lacks efficiency because it needs to enumerate all possible failure scenarios. In this talk, we present Yu, a general and efficient approach to verifying traffic load properties under arbitrary key failures. Let's start with an example network. A prefix is advised into three autonomous systems at 300, 200, and 100. The flow F1 enters at 100 at router A. The first route at router A has router C at its next hop and passes through two axes at 100 and at 300. The second route passes through three axes at 100, at 200, and at 300. The route with fewer axes in the S path is preferred over the other, so all traffic is forwarded to router C. At router C, the next hop is determined by route iteration from the BGP protocol to the AZ protocol. We omit the details and give the result. All traffic is routed through link C2E. Now suppose link K2C fails. The first route at route A becomes unavailable. The traffic is routed through the second route. There are two routes in router B's routing table, but neither is preferred over the other because their S-passes are the same. Thus, the traffic will be equally forwarded to both router C and router D. Router D is configured with some terminals that distribute 20% of the received traffic over path D2 C2E and the remaining 80% over path D2E. Finally, router C forwards all traffic it receives over link C2E. As the example shows, R1 runs over a distributed control plan with complex routing protocols such as EBGP, IBGP, and AZs that interact through route selection and route iteration. Equal cost multiple paths, or ECMP, is used for route balancing. SR terminals are configured for traffic scheduling, resulting in known shortest path forwarding. This is a further change. You must be general enough to support all these network features. To address the change of generality, We propose the symbolic execution is a better approach called the symbolic traffic execution. Which is failures at symbolic inputs. For simplicity, we consider only the states of links A to C, B to C, and B to D, represented by x1, x2, and x3. For example, x1 equals to false means that link A to C is unavailable. You then use this symbolic traffic execution to compute the symbolic traffic load for each link, which is a function that maps failure scenarios to the traffic load under that failure scenario. After that, you can verify whether any link would be loaded under key failures by proving or disproving the formula related to the symbolic traffic load. To be general, symbolic traffic execution must reflect the exact forwarding behavior of the router. Thus, we need to start with symbolic representations of routing tables. You use this 火眼 to obtain a routing table in which each route is guarded by a formula that describes under which failure scenarios the route will present. For example, the route with network C at route B is guarded with 2, meaning that the route exists only if link B to C is leave. The second route at route A exists when either link B to C or link B to D is leave, so it is guarded with L2 or X3. Based on the guarded routing tables, the next step is to build formulas to describe the forwarding behavior of the router. Next, we discuss two primitives, route selection and ECMP. For other primitives, such as route iteration and S-tunneling, please refer to our paper. For module route selection, we use SR to denote whether R is selected. Then SR can be computed from root guards. Here, the first part ensures that R itself is present, and the second part ensures that more preferred routes are not present. We refer to two routes at route A as R1 and R2. We next implement SR2 as an example. Here, X2 or X3 means that the second route itself is present, and not S1 means that the first route is not present. To module ECMP, we use CR to denote the ratio of traffic forwarded by R to traffic entering the router. First, to have a known zero ratio, the route must be selected, as shown in the numerator. Second, if there are multiple routes selected, the ratio is the inverse of the number of selected routes, as shown in the denominator. We use RA and RB to denote the two routes at router B. As an example, we next explain the meaning of CRA. If both routes exist, 50% of traffic would be forwarded by the first pass. However, if only the first route exists, 100% of traffic will be forwarded by that route. Next, you perform the symbolic traffic execution to compute the symbolic traffic load. For simplicity, we assume that the flow F1 carries one unit of traffic. First, route A forwards the traffic to router C and B according to the ratios CR1 and CR2, as well as router B. By repeating the process, the symbolic traffic load on each link can be computed. So far, we have talked about the symbolic traffic execution framework. The next question is how to efficiently represent symbolic formulas. More specifically, R1 requires you to have efficient formula encodings that should be able to scale to 1,000 routers, tens of thousands of links, millions of routes on each router, billions of flows per hour, and hundreds of millions of failure scenarios. This poses the second challenge of Yu, efficiency. After listing all the symbolic formulas, we can notice that first, they are all pseudo-Boolean functions, that are functions that map Boolean variables to real numbers. Secondly, need lots of arithmetic the operations. Based on the observations, we decided to use the multi-terminal binary decision diagram (MTBD), which is the perfect fit to encode these formulas. MTBD is a single-source multiple-sync directed cyclic graph, where nodes represent Boolean variables. Edges represent assignments made of such variables, and terminal represent the values. Furthermore, we use f at x1 equal to false to denote the sub-MTBD or the left subgraph of the x1 node. MTBD has been extensively studied and it can support Boolean or arithmetic operations in a relatively efficient way. However, the size of MTBD still explodes after operations, so we need to develop more novel automation techniques for Yu to make its efficiency scale to our production one. Our insight is that many nodes are not used for under K failure scenarios. For example, under one failure scenario, if we know S2 is false, all other variables must be true. So S1 not S2 is equivalent to not S2. Performing one failure equivalence reduction on the left MTBD should remove the X1 node, resulting in a simpler MTBD at the right. Formally, we use beta KF to denote the result of the K failure equivalence reduction for MTBD F. First, if C is the terminal, K failure equivalence reduction does nothing, as shown by the blue arrow in the example. Second, zero failure equivalence reduction always results in a terminal, since no more failures are allowed. This is shown by the red arrow in the example. Third, if K-1 failure equivalence reduction of two sub-MTBDs provides the same result, as in the example where the blue and the red arrows point to the same MTBD, the source node can be removed to obtain a simpler MTBD, as shown by the purple arrow in the example. Otherwise, we perform equivalence reduction recursively for sub-MTBDs. In our paper, we formally prove that using K-failure equivalence reduction preserves K-failure traffic working results. Put all the above together, we can compute the symbolic traffic load of link C2E on the one failure scenarios. Finally, verifying traffic load properties can be done as simple as examining whether all terminals in the K failure reduced MTBD satisfy these properties. As shown in the theorem, with detailed proofs can be found in our paper. The next part of my talk is the intellectual case study and performance evaluation of Yu. Yu has been deployed in R1 for months and has detected some real risks. Here is an example. Destin 1 sends traffic to Destin 2. Our operators configure as terminals to force forward traffic from Destin 1 to the Anycast RP 1.1.1.1 and then from the Anycast RP to Destin 2. In a normal case, traffic is equally distributed to the blue path as well as the red path. Now suppose link B2 to C2 fails. Our operators expected that the second path to be unavailable, so all traffic would be forwarded through the blue path. However, the expected behavior is incorrect. In fact, the routers will still forward traffic to the router B2, and the traffic would then go to B1 over link B2 to B1, but link B2 to B1 was never designed to carry such a large amount of traffic, so link would be overloaded. This problem is hard to notice without the help of Yu. We report this problem to our operators and receive confirmation. We evaluated Yu's performance on networks of various sizes, including the production 1 and 3 subnetworks. It takes less than 5 minutes to verify the entire one for one link failures, and less than 30 minutes for two link failures. With 448 times faster than 金箍棒, a network unable for two link failures. We also evaluated synthetic datasets. FD12 with a network of factory topology with 12 ports containing about 1,000 links. The verification time for two link failures on FD12 with 42.3 times faster than that of QARC, and 15.4 times faster than that of Jingguang. We evaluated the effects of optimizations. In FT4, applying K-failure MTBE reduction max of 339 times faster. In conclusion, Yue is the first system that is able to verify traffic load properties on the arbitrary key failures at the production scale. We highlight that the combination of symbolic execution and MTBEs with novel optimizations yields production-ready generality, scalability, and efficiency. Meanwhile, we have been using Yue Production One for months and have detected real risks that have been confirmed by our operators. This is the end of my talk. Thank you for listening.